question again. Yes, no. If yes, why am I feeling this way? And then you trace back. Oh, that one time someone cussed me out at the street, whatever. Or, I don't know, I had this random thought that triggered a memory, that triggered my trauma, that triggered this feeling, that triggered me to cry, that triggered me to break a face. I don't care. And then that triggered me to have to clean it up, and now I'm angry, and that triggered me to shout, and then that triggered me to, you know, you can make a flowchart and a mental process in your head. You know, it's important not to impress it, like to cause that impression to form and develop as a permanent seed in your mind, but however, you just let the emotion flow, let it go, okay? Let the emotion flow, let it go. It's important, okay? We're gonna say that one more time, let the emotion flow, and let it go. So when you get that thought in your mind, you can process it, but don't impress it. Process it, but don't impress it. We're not trying to impress that thought, okay? You don't want to be like, come here, I'm trying to impress you into my mind. No, you want to say, shoo, go away, you know? So that you don't do that to other people and say, shoo, go away unconsciously. Does that make sense? Because when you impress it, you impress whatever negative thing that negative emotion has, and you are identified with it, you are part of it, and now they're working through your conscious and psyche to act as you, as if a different persona. So, only associate and identify and impress with those positive feelings and thoughts, okay? So, when we think about heavy things like chakras, meditations, colors, wolves, whatever, you know, we can associate with a good feeling with it, and then some people will look at this picture and be like, ooh. And I know I always get this in the comments, there's always someone who just isn't satisfied with anything, and that's okay, you know, that's their process. And hopefully this video helps them in some way. Ooh, I'm scared of wolves. Ooh, that gives me a bad vibe. It looks creepy. Or, what is that? That looks like a, I don't know, whatever they come up with. I don't, it's not my vibration, so I can't even think of it right now. Or, oh my god, your lips are too blue. Like, that's the perfect one. First of all, honey, why'd you click? Second of all, do you see the effort I put to match colors and coordinate? No, it's okay. It's not about that, but, basically, you know, they have one day impressed a negative thought about dogs or wolves. It might not even be that. Maybe it reminds them of the night and it scares them and get their nightmares. You don't know. So, it's kind of like that psychological test where the ink blots, where everyone has a different projection of what that is. Like, for example, all I see are butterflies. Every single one is a butterfly. I don't know why, but butterflies I associate with the spirit world and something positive. And so that's kind of like the influence, kind of spiritual, whatever, I revolve around this wolf. And I can only share my experience with you, but reminds me of the night. That's why I mentioned it. The moon and mystery because of the purple, so it's mysterious. I like dogs. I like wolves. I like animals. So this I really like. So I put it up, and then that, of course, is, I don't know if you can see it from this far away, but it is a picture of a person sitting in meditation, and then the colors of the chakra are rainbow all around them, and it's